Just a pre-video disclaimer here. I realize that I hold my camera kind of funny, and I happen to put my index finger over top of the microphone, and this causes some audio issues. So I'm going to be putting this clip in front of all of the videos I have for my California trip. Because all of them have some sort of screwed up audio at some point. Here is the start of your scheduled video. There you are. So I didn't have anything planned for today, but I went and looked up Universal. So we are going to go to Universal Studios Hollywood today. It's about a 40-minute Uber. That's not bad. It's about the same distance from here to the airport. Some things I want to talk about at the room. So just sitting on the bed, like it like sinks completely down. I didn't think it was going to be comfortable to sleep in it, but it actually wasn't bad at all. I actually prefer this bed to the one in the Marriott, surprisingly. I didn't think that I would. The pillows, though, I don't care so much for. Marriott definitely had the better pillows. What I thought was weird is that they're square, well, squarish. They're very small for the size of the bed because it's a king bed. So you would think that the pillows would be a little bigger, but also they only gave me three, which really isn't that big of a deal because it's just me. I usually use two, but you would think that usually it's four. So yeah, that was kind of weird. I did mention yesterday how I could hear the kids at the pool. There was some really weird noise coming from upstairs, I think it was. When I first heard it, I actually thought it might have been an earthquake, but then it just kept happening regularly. I think it was people going up and down the stairs, like very aggressively. And now I'm pretty sure the person above me is taking a shower. It sounds like there's water running, which isn't really a big deal. It's just not something that you would expect to hear in a hotel, especially for what I paid to stay here. I will say this place definitely was not worth the price for what it was. Still got four more nights here. Gonna make the best of it. There's like it's not bad, it's just not great either. There's other places that I saw walking to downtown Disney yesterday that I would much rather have stayed in than here. But too late for that now. One of the major selling points of this hotel though, or this room, is the shower. The shower was great. I very much enjoyed the shampoo and body wash and stuff is very good products. I actually like them better than the stuff at the Marriott. Water pressure was good, water temperature was good. Yeah, so shower, best part about this hotel. I'm also randomly watching Harry Potter. It's the only thing I could find on TV because I am up well before I need know where I need to be up. Well, made it to Universal, and right up front there's a booth of the Pepsi. I didn't realize that they were a chain.
Literally donuts.
Might have to go and get breakfast there. So, donuts were good. They weren't bad. Along the lines of Dunkin' Donuts quality. They were probably made today, but they weren't like fresh out of the oven or anything. The pretzel in the voodoo doll donut was stale, and there was only a little bit of jelly in there, like right towards the end. But both donuts were good. The coffee is really good. Park opens in like 40 minutes, so I'm gonna go head towards the entrance now.
Just waiting to get into the park.
Theme park in Los Angeles for the day to have fun. How's that sound? Light these candles and get this party started. We will begin chanting tickets in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, scream! That's right, guys. Thanks. If you have your tickets printed out, please hand them out to each member of your party. And if you have your
in the park, they let us in about 20 minutes early. Yeah, about 20 minutes early. I have no idea what to do here. Like, I know close to nothing about this park. And I might be wrong on this, but I can't find any park maps either. So I'm just gonna wander around the park completely blind, see what I can find. Look at that hearse. I have no idea where this crowd's going. Should probably follow them. I'm guessing this is something for Halloween Horror Nights. Maybe some food booths. Oh, figured out where we're all going. We are going the Hogsmeade.
Where's Hogwarts?
So, did the Hogwarts ride. I can never remember what that's called. It was really good. Made me a little sick. I took Dramamine because most Universal rides tend to make me sick. I forgot that about the locker thing, so couldn't take my phone I probably could have taken my phone and stuff in there with me, but last time I got on that ride, I thought my phone was going to fall out of my pocket, so I decided to put it in the locker. It was a really good ride. A lot of stuff that was cool in the queue that I couldn't show you, but It was really dark in there anyway, so it doesn't matter, you want to be able to see it. But explored Hogsmeade for a bit, and now I'm going to continue wandering around, because I still have no idea what's actually here. But it looks like we're going into Springfield next.
It's funny that this is here, because this is still technically a Disney IP. Is this going to go away eventually, or do Universal and Disney have something worked out? It would be expensive to change all this over into something else.
Chamber of Secret. You'll see Brian's and Nissan Skyline from Too Fast, Too Furious. The car was never sold in the US. It is the right-hand drive model, the side they drive in Japan. You'll see the Gyrosphere from Jurassic World, the round one, Sony. Jurassic World, starring Chris Pratt, Ed Bryce, Dallas Howard, and B.D. Wong, is our highest grossing film in history. The Fallen Kingdom was another great hit. Dominion is now in the theaters. Right now, we are taking you to an island off the coast of Costa Rica.
Don't move!
Oh, there they are! In reality, the vehicle was suspended by a crane on top of one of our parking structures that was dressed to look like a massive cliff wall. Our grease department, with a combination of real and of a tropical rainforest, but it's our special effects team that supplies the atmosphere. In Jurassic Park films, extreme weather conditions play an important role in setting just the right mood. This location is perfect for the show. We are now in Old Mexico. So the show is about to start. water straight up in here. The water falls back down naturally, and that's how we create rain for movies and TV shows. It's really simple, but really quick and effective. Our special effects team did a fantastic job. Thank you so much, guys. You guys can stop right now. Thank you. Appreciate it. Excuse me, guys. Stop right.
Okay, how come they're not stopping it?
Uh-oh. Do you guys hear a low rumbling noise coming from the top of the hill? Something's wrong. I think we opened it, right? We opened it. Oh, we're going to get something wet.
Designed around the vision that Steven had.
So, just got off the studio tour. It was actually pretty cool. They had some cool effects. Not that I remember it very well, but it definitely reminded me of the Backlot tour. MGM, Hollywood Studios. It was really cool. There was some screen-based stuff, but only a little bit. So, I don't feel sick getting off this ride. It was a lot longer than I expected it to be. It was probably about 40 minutes. But it was really cool, definitely worth the time spent on it. That's what we were just on. Super Nintendo World.
that is opening next year, I believe.
Gotta make sure to get the shoe cleaners. So that's what those things are for, right? So that was pretty interesting. So, Universal Studios Hollywood is divided into two different levels, as far as I can tell. And well, because of how it's built on the mountain, basically. And I had to just take four different escalators down to the lower level. It actually took like 10 minutes just to get down here because of all the escalators and stuff. And there are some staircases which probably would have been quicker to go down, but not everyone has a staircase, so I didn't even notice that there was a staircase on the last escalator. So.
Eyes up, look at how she is lynching that perimeter. You see Blue's awareness on full display. She's incredibly curious and analytical. So not only is Blue taking in information about her surroundings, she is...
I think now it's time to check out Jurassic World.
The Jurassic Park version of it in Orlando. I definitely like this one better. The Orlando version definitely needed an upgrade, which this one has. Even though I think I've seen the first Jurassic World movie, but I've never really seen this movie. But it's a very good ride, and the first Universal ride that I had, water ride that I got off of, that I wasn't completely soaked.
A vegetarian corndog from Many Eats, and tan dip. That's really good. So do the fries. Fries are definitely really good.
Really good corn dog, actually. I've had vegetarian corn dogs before. I would rather have this. And that's the inside. This is a really good corn dog, though. So I was really impressed, actually, with how good that corn dog was. It was like
$12
for it. Came with a side of fries and.
It was most definitely worth it. It was right next to the mummy ride. It is probably some of the best value for what you paid for here. Considering that corn dog was actually huge. But now it's time to ride the mummy.
Make me sick, but I have motion sickness issues. It wasn't screen based. I just got sick from the way that the ride actually moves. I will say it is much different from Orlando's version. It's still a really good ride. It's much shorter, but it is a different ride. Same style ride, just not the same. So, is it kind of weird that they have a merch store for themed area that's not actually open yet, not even finished being built yet. You would think that they would want to hold on to the merch until opening day or whatever. But I don't know. I wouldn't want to buy anything from in there. There wasn't anything in there that really caught my interest, but I wouldn't want to buy anything in there before the park, before it actually opens.
This will be where the entrance to the land will be, at least that's what I'm assuming.
To see if there's any shows.
What is this thing? That is obnoxious and scary.
Vegetarian tamale, beans, and rice. And they serve it on a corn husk for some reason. So, the tamale was pretty good. And the rice and beans were definitely sitting under a heat lamp. So, it was okay. The corn dog was definitely a better value than what I paid for the tamale, but it was okay. I'd go back to that place again, the Mexicana, whatever, but I would definitely get something else over the tamale. But came back into Hogsmeade and found a whole other area I didn't even go into yet. So I'm gonna check that out. And actually, there wasn't much back there, just some weird side passage.
So now we're waiting for the special effects show. Starts 2:45. I've got about 25 minutes.
Safeties. You see, Nate is applying something to his face. It's not the latest Hollywood beauty cream. It's a protective fire gel, and he applies it to all of his exposed skin. You probably know how uncomfortable it is that Mrs. Bob with sunblock will imagine what it must feel like to Mrs. Bob when you're on fire. Not good. Yeah. The safeties are standing by the fire extinguisher in case of early ignition.
Excuse me, Chris. We're ready for you.
Go right ahead.
Jay, you ready? Fueling.
Upon completion of the burn, Nate will move down to this fire blanket, where he will be extinguished. At this point, we are looking for a thumbs up that he is okay. Thumbs down. It's a sign to get our medical team involved. Also, excellent time for me to point out that these are trained stunt professionals using specialized equipment. It's not the type of thing anyone should ever think about trying on their own. It looks like Nate's just wearing a pair of jeans and a shirt. In truth, it's the safety layers underneath that give him a little added protection. Nothing is going to make him completely fireproof, but each layer buys him a little extra time when he needs it the most. Because the last thing a fire performer wants to hear at the end of the take is, all right, let's shoot that again. One take, you got it. For this scene, you're hoping he can burn for about 8 to 10 seconds. That will be our goal. I think we're about ready to go. Take our lights down, set our clock to zero. At this time, we do need to ask that everybody please remain seated for the duration of this stunt. Stunt team, whenever you're ready.
Thank you. Jay, you ready?
Ready.
Nate, you ready to burn?
Ready.
Stunts is ready.
Ready and action.
Lighting. You're lit!
So whenever the tamale that I got at the Mexicana place, it's giving me some. really bad heartburn. That's why I got the ice cream. It helped a little bit. But now I think I'm gonna go over to Griffith Observatory. So after getting stuck in a bunch of traffic, finally made it over to the observatory. Went to get out here while it was still light out, but yeah, that's not happening because there is apparently a concert going on at the Greek Theater, which I didn't know was like a mile away from the observatory. And you can see the Hollywood sign, kinda. This is why I wanted to get out here while you still light out so I could actually see it, but I thought it would be bigger. And here's a random Birkin chair. It's also very cold out. I mean, it's probably in the high 60s, but we're on top of the mountain and it's windy. I am cold.
It's an observatory.
So, for the first time ever, I was actually asked for my vaccination card. At least I brought it inside the observatory now. This is working now.
Well, kind of is the case, but the reason why is we do have...
That was kind of weird. I've been wandering around there for at least an hour. Walked past several security and employees. And then they're finally, as I'm walking out, they're like, you need to put on a mask. I'm like, okay. I don't have one. But they gave me one to walk 10 feet out the door. But looking at the moon through that telescope, that was amazing. It's well worth the trip up here alone. So now I'm going to attempt to get an Uber and go back to the hotel. So I just got back to the room. The observatory was really cool. Could kind of see the Hollywood sign. I'm not sure how well that'll show up on camera. But that's part of the reason why I wanted to get there during the day. But that didn't happen. Because there was a concert going on at the Greek, which apparently is in a really nice neighborhood. That was kind of weird. I've never seen a major concert venue in, a nice part of town. It's just a really out of place to have a concert venue, but whatever, this place is famous. And you can actually see it from the observatory. If you walk out on one side and look down, you can see it. I could hear the music from there. The observatory was really cool. It's actually a free museum. I didn't think that I was going to be able to go in there, but you're allowed. And it was like $10 for a show. I didn't, the planetarium show. I didn't do that. But it was cool. I'd go back. I did want to check out Sunset Boulevard as well, but because of the concert at the Greek, it didn't work out too well. I mean, I could have taken an Uber over there, but that it just wasn't working. Not to mention, it took me like an hour to get an Uber back to the hotel anyway. So, that's going to be it for the day. It was a really good day. We'll say Universal Hollywood doesn't have a lot of stuff there. Like, I did everything that I was interested in doing. Like, as far as rides go, I was done 12:30. And then I went and got some food and stuff and just sort of wandered around. And the park was only open till 6, which is fine because it was a Halloween Horror Night. And obviously I didn't need the extra time anyway. There's just not a lot to it. It's such a weird place coming from, not that I've been to Universal Orlando a lot, but they're two very different places. But that is going to be the end of the video, and I will see you in the next one.